Hi, I'm Chris, and I work at the developer relations team at Google. How would you like to improve the look of your app using the new material styling in Android L? I'm going to show you how to do this along with some of my Bainesy top tips. But first, here's an introduction to the new material design principles. They've been created to work across all devices from Android to the web, and are a comprehensive guide for the visual, motion, and interaction design for apps. Now to go on this journey, we need a sample app. We'll be using XYZ Reader, which you may remember from the show Android Design in Action. Now this app already utilises some of the things which we associate with a good Android app. Things like branding for a colour on the action bar, responsive touch feedback, the use of standard type sizes, prominent use of imagery both on the list and the detail UIs. Now our goal is to make it look like this. So let's get started. Now, the first step is to change the app's theme to inherit from one of the new material themes available in Android L. There are equivalent material themes for the majority of the Holo themes which your apps are using. Our sample app uses Dark Action Bar as its base theme, so here we will create a new styles XML file in the values v21 folder, redefining our existing theme.bacon theme to inherit from the material version of the Dark Action Bar theme. And after we've done that, we'll have something that looks like this. Now, there are a number of things you may notice here. The action bar is now more colourable by default, and this ties in with the encouraged use of colour in your UIs. Clickable items now receive the new ink fill touch feedback, and overall the metrics have changed, as space is now treated differently. So we haven't yet customised the material theme, so let's go ahead and add our branding colour back into the app. But before we do that, let's take a step back and see what you need to do with Holo to achieve this kind of customisation. Here is a small section of our styles file. We're only customising the action bar, and you can already see that the main theme is pretty complex. If you also start customising any of the standard widgets, such as button or edit text, your styles file can easily become hundreds of lines long. Now there are obvious downsides to this, the fact that it's hard to maintain and update, but you also need to bundle colourised drawables in your app, such as these, which adds unnecessary bloat. Now luckily there are tools such as Action Bar Style Generator and Android Holo Colours which make this pretty easy. But wouldn't it be nice if we could do this without having to put so much work into it? Now the good news is that the new theming functionality in Android L allows us to accomplish this without needing to bundle those drawables or style definitions. This new functionality allows you to declare your colour scheme in your main style, and this is done by setting new attributes, the most important two being colour primary and colour primary dark. Colour primary is your app's main branding colour, and is used by the app bar, scrolling edge effects and other built-in widgets. Colour Primary Dark, as the name suggests, is a darker variant of Colour Primary and is used to colour the contextual action bar, amongst other things. So back to our sample app, our styles file becomes the following, with Colour Primary and Colour Primary Dark set to two colours from resources, Bacon and Crispy Bacon. And after that, our sample app looks like this. You can see that the action bar and edge effects have changed colour to fit our colour scheme.
Bainesy's top tip.
Internally, a lot of this is allowed for the new drawable tinting functionality. This is a great new feature which allows you to easily recolor drawables at runtime. Here is a drawable defined in XML which specifies a red tint, using another drawable as the source. There's also the set tint method on drawable to achieve the same thing. Now the next step is to look at the layout of the app. The material design principles introduce a new way to think about the space in your app, using baseline grids and keylines to promote consistency across the system as a whole. A level down from that, we will now also provide detailed guides about space, padding, and overall metrics for the most commonly used containers and elements, things such as lists, grids, and buttons. Now it's important to note that for the most part, these metrics are not provided by the framework, meaning that you need to implement them yourself in your layouts. We also now have a set of standard type styles and scales. Each one of these has been chosen to balance content density with reading comfort for the user. Combined with the new Roboto font used in Android L, which is rounder and wider, these styles should give your text content greater clarity. So back to our sample app. We're going to convert our list into a grid, which will allow our imagery to be more prominent and aid quick visual comprehension. To do that, we're going to take the grid container guide and apply it to our list of meats. Each container guide tends to have a number of different variants to allow flexibility for the type of content you're trying to show. Here, we are going to use the two-line variant. There are other variants in the grid component guide, which differ on the number of lines of text or graphics each item displays. So let's look more in depth at the guide. Each item displays a square image along with two lines of text, which can either overlay the image or be in line. It specifies the type fonts and sizes, along with a 4-digit spacing for all items. In this variant, we have two options for the text sizes, either 16 SP for the first line and 12 for the second, or 14 SP for both. Now, which one you use depends on the relative importance of your text. And after doing that, this is what it will look like. Each item is easier to parse for the increased size of the imagery, and we've minimized the amount of text which needs to be displayed. Now, obviously, we have only gone through one screen here, and most apps will have more than this. You will need to read through the design guide, applying all of the appropriate layout guides to your app's UI.
Benzies, top tip.
You're going to be using the standard keylines a lot in your apps, so instead of hardcoding the values in your layouts, make sure you're declaring them in your dimension resources. Here are three to get you started, but there are many more which can be added here. And now we move on to imagery. Now, imagery is one of the key principles in the new design language and should be used to show relevance, convey information, and generally delight the user. Now, for this section, we're going to focus on the detail screen of the app. The current layout already uses imagery with its full bleed banner image, but we're going to improve things by making it more immersive. The way we're going to do that is by using the translucent status bar functionality, which was added in Android KitKat. Now, doing this allows us to make the app bar translucent when the content is scrolled all the way to the top, and thus allows the imagery to bleed into the app's Chrome. We then bring the app bar back into view when the image and title are scrolled out of view. Now, this technique is not reliant on any new functionality in Android L, so you can use it on past versions. And indeed, many apps on Google Play already do this. You may have seen it in the Google Play Music app. We have also brought the title and subtitle into view by moving them out of the image and into their own contrasting layout, again using the app's primary colour to emphasise our brand. And finally, the body text has been tweaked to match the body typographic style from the design guide. So finally, here's our end result again. As a quick recap, our branding colour is now used throughout the app, both of the screens are using the new base grids and keylines, and we have emphasised our imagery on the detail UI by making it more immersive.
Benzies, top tip!
Are you wondering how to implement a fading action bar with translucent status bar? Well, Roman Urich posted a great Android developer's pro tip on exactly this recently. As part of that, he wrote the draw insets frame layout, which makes it really easy. You can grab the code from his GitHub gist. But the fun doesn't stop there. So to help your app reach the sky, here are some more things we have added for this release. Activity scene transitions, which allow you to use the scene and transitions API when you are transitioning from activity to activity. Recycler view is our next generation adaptive view, intended to replace list view and grid view. Recycler view has been designed so that the logic for laying out items is pluggable, meaning that you now have complete control over how your items are laid out. Android has gone 3D with elevation and translation Z. So as well as being able to move views in the X and Y axis, you can now move in the Z axis. And this allows your views to come away from the screen, casting a real-time shadow to create depth to your UIs. And finally, floating action buttons are a new type of button which are reserved for your most important actions. They're recognizable as a circular icon which floats above your UI. So thanks for watching. Now show us what you can do.